States. It's about 500,000 vehicles per year. Also where we get our military vehicles and equipment and the rental vehicles to and from Hawaii. Now starting with our large Navy ship here at the end, number 6. It's the USS America, first of the America's class amphibious assault ships. Also the fourth warship, named after the United States of America. And also the only amphibious ship that's not amphibious. I'll explain that in a minute. Now our next gear up, we have a similar ship, which is amphibious. It's called the Macon Island. First of the Navy's hybrid amphibious assault ships. And that hybrid has to do with the engines. But the backside of this ship has a feature called the well deck and stern gate. Remember that, and we'll explain that in a minute as well. Left side of the dock, the big Z on the back, one of my favorite ships, the USS Sunwall. One of the newest, largest, and most technologically advanced surface defense in the world. That's the lead ship in a class of next-generation multi-mission destroyers that have been designed to strengthen naval power at sea. They have a state-of-the-art electronic propulsion system which can power a small to medium-sized city. Wave-piercing, tumble-home hull, stealth design, and the latest warfighting technology and weaponry available. You look right to its front side, it has two 155mm cannons, and the whole ship has 80 advanced vertical launch subs, which means she can fire 12 missiles at once, about 600 total. Side of the dock, a couple of destroyers. Russell's on the front and the back. You have 113, the John Finn. She was named after the Great Irish and went on the receiving end during World War II. Left side of the dock, another one of our amphibious transport docks, which are also known as the MD for short. And up to that next year, ship with all the cranes on it, we have the USNS Curtis. That's one of our aviation logistics ships.
Assault ship. But what does it mean for a ship to be amphibious?